after World War II, the great European empires, which had controlled so much of the world, from Africa to Asia, looked as though they would never rise again. British wartime Prime Minister Winston Churchill was persuaded by US President Franklin Roosevelt into committing to the agreement known as the Atlantic Charter, the terms of which effectively made it impossible for Britain to return to its imperial status quo after the war, and thereby triggered the global wave of 20th century decolonization, starting with Indian independence. In this video, we will learn about India's involvement in the Second World War. When acknowledging India's involvement in the Second World War, the focus tends to be on Indian soldiers. Almost 2 million soldiers went to war and only 26 lakh by the end of it returned. The war also involved Indian airmen and sailors, in smaller numbers, but effectively transformed the Indian Air Force and Navy even more than the Army. Indian Air Force personnel served in the skies over England and France in the early years of the war, and also in the Middle East and North Africa. Indian naval personnel served in the Mediterranean, the Middle East and Southeast Asia. The war also gave a huge fillip to India's economy, industrialization and employment. By the end of the war, India had, incredibly, spent more on it than Britain. On independence, Britain owed India a considerable sterling debt. Indians participated in the war for a variety of reasons, sometimes out of economic compulsion, but war service actually opened up opportunities for professional growth and social advancement, both for the then still tiny Indian middle class as well as for marginalized groups. Not to forget, the appearance of women in offices and paid jobs was part of the war effort. Many Indian political leaders of the time, including the Mahatma, discreetly encouraged Indian individuals to participate. Their aim, defense analyst Shashank Joshi observes waspishly, was not to wind up India's preeminence, but to inherit it. The war brought many global personalities who would later become celebrities to India, among them writer Eve Curie, daughter of Nobel laureates Marie and Pierre Curie, naval officer Ian Fleming, future author of the James Bond novels, and RAF pilot Ezra Weizman, future president of Israel. Social issues the world faces today are sadly similar to some from that era, including identity issues and discrimination. Experiences of the 1940s depended on caste, class, vantage point and region. A Punjabi soldier could see things very differently to a metropolitan student in Mumbai, formerly Bombay, or a factory owner in Kolkata, Calcutta. Often those who worked towards the war were Anglo-Indians, Adivasis, tribespeople, Parsis and Christians, and their histories slipped by the wayside during the writing of post-independence nationalist myth. It was May 1944, and a small group of British Indian soldiers was under assault by an entire division of Japanese forces. Needless to say, they were the toughest enemy any British army has had to fight. According to military historian Robert Lyman, the Battle of Kohima and Imphal changed the course of the Second World War in Asia. The Japanese invasion of India, of which the Battle of Kohima was a significant part, was British first major defeat in the Far East. One reason was the British partition of India soon after, according to Charles Chassier, a historian based in Nagaland. Battle of Kohima was seen more as a colonial war, while the post-war discourse focused more on the Indian independence struggle led by the Indian leader, Mahatma Gandhi. On top of everything else, that was a period of utter ruination of rural economies in India, partly because of the diversion of food to the war effort. How India dealt with all those challenges is all.